tequilasunriseanemone. They're just one of more than 1,000 sea anemone species. Sea anemone can be found in ocean waters all over the world, from the shallow tidal zones to the depths of up to 10,000 meters or 33,000 feet. These tequilasunriseanemone are not to be mistaken for corals or plants. This underwater predator may seem like a flower, but is actually a marine animal. These fascinating sea anemones are able to reproduce in different ways in comparison to other sea creatures. Most anemones do not stick to only one type of reproduction. They could reproduce by splitting, budding, or by producing sperm and eggs. There are a variety of factors that had led to my tequila sunrise spreading like crazy. Longitudinal fission is where the anemone tears itself in two or more fragments, usually from the base or from the mouth. One single anemone could split in half and form two anemones. Also, these anemones may reproduce smaller babies on the side of their base. Over time, and given proper nurturing and care, my tequila sunrise anemone have grown in numbers by splitting. Currently, there are more than 30 anemones in my aquarium tank. A well-kept reef tank is important for sea anemone growth and longevity. Anemones can be quite sensitive to sudden adjustments to water conditions. Any subtle change to water conditions could cause the anemone to reproduce in quantity. I have noticed my tequila sunrise reproduce over time as a result of regular water change. I schedule my water changes twice a week to ensure my reef tank is well maintained and clean. Lighting is also a crucial element to the growth and reproduction of sea anemone in a reef tank. The high quality lighting mimics the natural light that a sea anemone would receive in a reef environment. I ensure the spectrum of colors, blue, violet, and UV rays are tuned to suit the amount of light needed for my anemone. My lighting period is set to 8 hours in order to limit the amount of algae growth in the reef tank. With this amount of time, it provides sufficient lighting for anemone growth. Generally, anemones move closer to the ideal light source. If they do not have sufficient lighting, they tend to move around the tank. They will stretch their tentacles up toward the light to attain as much light source. Anemones contain zooxanthellae algae within their tissues to allow them to utilize light for nutrients. And this is why anemones require a lot of light. Sea anemone growth also depend on the amount of nutrients fed to them. Sea anemone could obtain nutrition in three different ways. They can capture their prey with their tentacles. Another way is to filter floating food particles as they land on the tentacles. Sea anemones can also capture food that has been released by other predators and wave action. The amount and type of food captured by the sea anemone depends on the number and size of an anemone's tentacles. Sea anemone are not able to control the flow of water across their bodies, and they rely on the water currents to bring their nutrients to them. In aquariums, sea anemones could be fed pellets, mysis shrimp, raw prawn, or silversides as part of their diet. Anemone pellets may contain oils, fats, minerals, and a high source of protein, which is essential for an anemone growth. I feed my anemone every 2 to 3 days. Sea anemones spend most of their time attached to rocks, coral reefs, the seafloor, and other immovable objects. This particular bubble-tip anemone prefers to plant its foot in rock crevices. Until recently, my anemone has been splitting, nearly covering the entire rock work. But when their need arises, many anemones can move to another location. They detach themselves to drift with the water currents, or in some cases, they are able to travel short distances with an awkward stroke. I always take caution when caring for my tequila sunrise anemones. These anemones are able to relocate themselves around the tank, or they could possibly find themselves relocating near a prized coral and sting them. Getting caught in a wave maker is also another concern for a sea creature with a foot. Generally, many anemone fish make one host anemone their home. Here in my fish tank, the tequila sunrise anemone are home to the snowflake Ocellaris clownfish and other reef creatures such as my bicolor blenny, trochus, and turbo snails. Anemones have stinging tentacles, but clownfish are not bothered by them. As a matter of fact, clownfish live in symbiotic harmony with the anemone. Clownfish have a protective mucus that prevents it from being stung by the nematocysts. They help chase away other predatory fish that may attempt to consume the anemone. They help stir the water circulation with their fins, and they help to clean any parasites from the anemone. I've been fish keeping for 5 years now, and this hobby is one of the most rewarding, yet challenging hobbies that I've ever experienced. This hobby can be quite rewarding and joyous.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.